seems to me that there's at least 8 reasons why we would be ill-advised to follow a grammar syllabus, especially a grammar syllabus as enshrined in a typical course book. The first of these I'll call the process versus product problem. And I use the analogy of an omelette. You don't deduce how an omelette is made simply by looking at the finished product, nor can you make an omelette by carving up an existing omelette and putting the bits back together. And that's a little bit about what happens with a grammar syllabus. A grammar syllabus is a kind of linguist's conception of how language is structured after the event, but it doesn't tell us how language is acquired, particularly for second language learners. What we should be working from is the learner's grammar, not the linguist's grammar. In other words, the learner's grammar as it evolves and emerges. The second argument I would call the corpus argument, simply because it's driven or informed by what we now know about language from corpus studies particularly, and that is that the grammar syllabus is such a crude subset and misrepresentation of what grammar really is, particularly with its obsessive focus on the verb phrase and its the way that it conflates tense and aspect, for example, as if they were all about time. So this really, it's just not a reliable guide, apart from anything else, to what language is like. And that brings me to the third argument, I mean, related to that, which is that we tend to teach what is really essentially a grammar derived from written texts, as if it could be transferred into spoken language. We teach the grammar of writing for speaking. We now know a lot more about spoken grammar and the way that it differs from written grammar, but this is not really represented in syllabuses. And that moves on to the fourth point, which I would call the phraseological argument, and particularly with spoken language, we see that the bulk of spoken language is phrases that are strung together, phrases, chunks, or whatever you want to call them, so up to 60% apparently of spoken English, according to some estimates. So again, the focus on the grammar syllabus misrepresents what language actually in use is all about, which is phraseology. Related to that argument is the argument which I will call the emergence argument, which takes the view that language is an emergent, or grammar is an emergent property. It grows out of use. It's not a prerequisite for use, both in the first and the second language. As somebody said, grammar from this point of view is not a prerequisite for communication, but it's a byproduct of communication. And that, I think, suggests that maybe we're teaching things around the wrong way. If we start with communication and work on the grammar that emerges and that facilitates that communication, maybe that's the direction we should be going. The sixth problem I see is the kind of focus on forms problem, that the grammar syllabus, although it purports not to, but it tends to shift the focus onto the forms, the structures, as it were, and not to the meanings that they encode. We become obsessed with forms, particularly when our syllabus is labelled present continuous, present perfect, simple, continuous, etc. Related to that argument is the what I call the McNuggets argument, organising language into these neat teachable little units encourages a kind of transmissive view of language teaching, where we are, as the teacher, transmitting or delivering these little McNuggets of grammar that had been nicely detached from their context and segmented into bite-sized chunks, which is also good for testing. And I suppose the final point relates to that, to which what I call the backwash effect, that when the grammar syllabus drives a course, then all the texts in the course are chosen, if not because of their intrinsic interest necessarily, or what other language elements, features that they display, but simply because they enshrine the grammar structure of the day. Now, I'm not saying that we shouldn't teach grammar. I'm not taking that point of view. What I am saying is the starting point shouldn't be grammar, for all the reasons that I've outlined.